Now, for people who wouldn't know you in Canada, what would be that big thing that they know you from? It would be your YTV days, I guess.
Oh, absolutely. That was probably the height of my time in Canada. It was so amazing. I was on YTV for about 6 years on The Zone. So yeah, I think that was the height. And then before that, I was on the radio in Toronto.
What made you want to move over from radio to TV? What was the big thing?
Well, I always intended to be an actor. I grew up in a place called Scarborough, which is just outside of Toronto. And, I didn't really see any avenues on how to reach what I wanted to do, which was to be an actor. And I was very lucky. Radio kind of just came up. I was a manager at a Roots Canada store, and it was my habit at that time, and it still is now, to kind of just tell everybody what I wanted to do. So anybody that would come into the store, anybody that I met at, you know, a work function, I was telling them that I wanted to be an actor. And one night at a Roots holiday party, I met somebody, Quamster Monster, Kwame was his name, mm-hmm. and he had a hip-hop show on Kiss 92 at the time, and he liked my energy and put me on, and then I moved to the morning show, and then continuing to just tell everybody what I really wanted to be an mm-hmm. actor, the YTV opportunity came up, and we all fell in love. Me and YTV, we fell madly in love, and then we had 6 beautiful years together.
That's incredible. What, any fun memories looking back? What's that one thing that stands out from those days in YTV?
Oh, man. There's so many. I mean, I remember my very first day. I remember my first week. We had this gag going. I was with Pat Kelly. You remember him?
Yeah, boy, yeah, Pat, yeah.
So Pat Kelly, when I first came on, the gag was that he, you know, had been asking for a partner because he was lonely, and this box shows up in the parking lot of YTV, and inside box was me, but he couldn't really tell that it was me, or actually I don't really specifically. I just remember being in a box and Pat Kelly breaking me out, and those being my first moments on television. So that was really a huge highlight. Other than that, I mean, I think it was probably a lot of the interviews. Like, I got to interview some amazing people. It was all amazing. And all the characters I played, they're all highlights. Everything is a number one moment. Anything I did on YTV is probably my favorite moment of my whole life.
What kind of people did you get to talk to? You said interviews.
Brad Pitt was definitely
what?
A highlight.
Really?
I know. Yeah.
No, YTV? Why would kids don't know Brad Pitt?
I know. He did a movie called, oh man, what was it called? It was, Oh, it was called Sinbad. Sinbad, Legend of the Seven Seas.
Oh, he voiced it. That's right.
It was. And so, you know, I would interview anybody that put a kid's movie out. And because it was animated, I got to interview him and Catherine Zeta-Jones. And she was kind of rude, and he was amazing. He was so sweet. I just remember him saying my name through the whole interview, and him, anytime he said sugar, it just sent shivers down my spine. So he was incredible. Gary Marshall, who's a director, he was another one of my favorites. The list goes on and on. Chris Brown, before he was a troublemaker.
Put that lightly, troublemaker, yeah, that's good.
Yeah, so it's pretty great.
Now, you were Pat's co-host, so did you replace, was it PJ Phil before you? Is that how it went?
No, I don't think PJ Phil did The Zone. He had the music show. I think so.
Well, he did The Zone for a bit, and then he did go with Pat for a bit, and then they had a bunch of stuff together, and then he left.
Yes.
So maybe, yeah.
Yes.
People come and go.
People come and go. It's the nature of YTV, but man, does it ever stay strong and people just keep watching it. It really is such an important part of our childhoods as Canadians, I think.
It's crazy how much it sticks in your mind. I guess it's that time in your life, and like people, they remember you to this day, and because it was that time in their life, and you still get recognized. You find, you know, walking around, people say, "Hey, I remember you from YTV."
I do. I mean, I'm in the States now, so it's not over here. But whenever I fly home, it usually happens in the airport, like as soon as I land, and then it feels so amazing. Being on YTV was such a gift, and the audience is such a gift, because it's not like being a big celebrity where people mm-hmm. freak out. It's more of people feeling like they're your close friend, you know? So I would be in the mall and people would come up and immediately start chatting and then want to do my shopping with me. And I was never opposed to it. You know, I just felt like I had so many friends all across Canada. And it was incredible.
So what made you leave? What made you move down to the States?
I wanted to open myself up to some of the, you know, I really, really, truly want to be acting. And Canada it was great, but I just felt that I had reached sort of my peak and everybody knew me from YTV. So I didn't really see myself getting out of that world, out of that, you know, children's entertainment. Not that it was just for kids at all, but, you know, I just didn't see myself getting out of YTV. If I was in Canada, I wanted to be YTV, but I really did want to give myself the opportunity to do other projects. And so coming to the States was just sort of a crazy but logical move. And and it's been going pretty good. Like, I just did a movie with Cameron Crowe, which is a huge deal. I had some scenes with Bill Murray, which mm-hmm. is a dream come true.
Wow.
And I know. I'm still in awe. I got back from Hawaii before the holiday where we shot, and it was just an absolute dream come true. So slowly but surely, the fight over here has been much harder than it was in Canada. But I just can't wait for all of my YTV followers and viewers to see as the journey gets better. And I can't wait to be back on television for everyone, you know?
Anything in the future? Anything you're working on right now?
Yeah, I'm developing a show right now with Seth Rogen and Evan Goldberg, his writing partner.
Wow, hey, that's very cool.
I'm so excited. It's really in the early stages, but it's an idea that I had, and they love it, and so they came on as executive producers, and now we're just in the early stages of getting it made. And, you know, we looked at a lot of networks, but decided that the best place to make it would be on the internet. So that means that Canada will not have to wait to see it, and it's going to be amazing. I don't know how soon we're actually going to start shooting, but we've been meeting a lot lately, and momentum has picked up, and we should have it turning out pretty soon.
Well, I look forward to seeing more of you. You were actually just in that, was it For a Good Time Call? You were in that movie as well, right?
I was. Did you see it?
Yeah, I watched it. I loved it. I thought it was great.
Oh, thank you. A lot of dirty improv coming out of my mouth in that movie.
It's okay. It shattered the whole YTV persona, I guess, but hey. It had to be done.
It had to be. I guess it had to be done. Well, anytime you see me in anything, I want you to give me a call, and I would love to talk to you more.
Yeah, for sure. Well, I look forward to seeing what you're doing with Seth and everything in the future, and we'll definitely stay in touch. And I thank you so much for the time. It's been great to chat with you. As somebody who's, you know, familiar with your work over the years, so it's kind of cool to finally break that barrier and get you on the phone. So.
Amazing. Well, you can call me anytime.
Well, make sure to hold you to that. But thanks a lot, and best of luck to you, and we'll talk to you soon.
Okay, amazing. Goodbye, everyone. I love you, Canada, so much.